OKP is port one. And we got Ness Game & Watch. A low-tier battle here to start off Grand Finals. 1 second. Let me update that scorecard for you guys. And we are in Grand Finals. Lil Blue just casually having a conversation while playing his first set of Grand Finals. OKP just decides to... Okay. Never mind. It's going to say that OKP killed himself. Lil Blue decides to swap the roles on us, keeping it interesting. Lil Blue doing a lot of standing still, and it's not working out for him. Great spacing by Lil Blue. You can expect Lil Blue to be doing a lot of credit cards from the ledge this set, if he stays Game & Watch. And Lil Blue stands still again, gets hit in the face with a baseball bat, and the intimidation of getting hit with another one, of being embarrassed, was too great. Ducked too low. And Lil Blue's spacing has been pretty immaculate this game, especially as of late. Just creating a wall of forward airs. Pretty sure that was not intentional, that forward smash. Guess the reverse bear. Weak bear, and that's game. Gets the key spike. That was actually gorgeous. Lil Blue commenting on how sick that was. I agree. And we're going back to their mains, Pikachu Sheik. It's a whole new world. Clinical, chain grab, jumps out. That was a pretty needle and a unpretty forward air. Not sure what that was supposed to be. Oh, good spot dodge. But Pikachu's jabs. Lil Blue holding center stage fairly well. OKP is so clinical at reading those full hops. Downer is always a really good mix up. Almost one more strong back hair or a ledge hog will do it. Another chain grab. Will he get the fair though? No. Pretty consistent. Just goes for down throw chain grab into F tilt into fair, but missed it that time. Battlefield being a little cheeky. And that was not a jump to take. That thunder jolt does a lot of damage. Or not damage. There's a lot of pressure. Really, really critical in Pikachu's recovery. So Lil Blue actually faced off last week against OKP. Same situation, Lil Blue coming from losers, OKP and winners, and Lil Blue ended up taking grand finals, but the bracket reset there were some sketchy moments out here. I wasn't here last week for grand finals, but apparently there were pauses involved. So maybe a little salt going into this, but OKP and Lil Blue are fairly good friends. Really clean call out with that down tilt. And Lil Blue is just looking robotic right now. It is pretty. 3%. Will he take any more? Sorry, he did. That was, oh, ooh, press one. Ledge cancel down air was my favorite part of that combo. What was my favorite part about that combo? Nothing. It's a chain grab. No bias. Really unfortunate SD by Lil Blue. Lil Blue had a lot of momentum. But takes it back, takes the stock right back, and that's always a confidence boost. Oh, the invincibility pressure. Gets that's OKP. Good start to this neutral, but it's so important on last stock. And the up air is going to take it. He won the first game. Ooh. He stood up. He went for the handshake. Eek. 2-1. 2-1 OKP. Not sure if the underscore in the period are a part of his tag, but that's how it is on challenge. So that's how I'm putting it in. 3%. And the homie stock. That's clean. I salute that. And good karma nets him a chain grab, but thanks FOD. It's a good DI up on that down throw. Oh man, Lil Blue is just placing these tilts immaculately this game. The intercepting forward tilt has been, he's been nuts with those. Good DI to eliminate the chance of a up smash, and that is rough. Not looking very strong for OKP. Two SDs this game. According to a one Cream Puff, OKP, you know OKP is hot when he SDs. But not sure if I agree with that. Clean wall of back case. He is so consistent with that thunder. Lil Autismo. See if we're gonna get a bracket reset. Few damage taken. Was that a phantom? Phantom something. And here we go. Let's go big or go home for Lil Blue. Chain grab, gonna get him somewhere. Let's not get him all the way. And the back air is going to take it. Oh, man. Game five of set one. Are we going to see... Are we going to see a pop-off to get bodied? Misses the pivot. Another missed pivot up smash from OKP. Good bait on the up air. Smash. That could have easily been a thunder combo. Another SD from OKP. He is on fire. Ooh, just looks him straight in the face. Gives him a little slap for good measure. Ooh, there we go. That's going to take it. And here we go. Here we go. And the chain grab. How far is it going to take him? How you feeling? Are you feeling lucky? Trade and damage. Ooh. Ooh, he just waits. I am clenching. Am I your favorite, or are you being sarcastic? Down tilt to nothing, Cray. Incredible. Gets the up B. Oh. Up B to SD. True combo. Confirmed. So, reset. Bracket reset. Here we go. How much did that pop-off cost OKP? Is it going to cost him one set, or is it going to cost him two? Thank you, Rogue. Rogue, is that how you say that? Neutral games nuts, the stock. I'm liking it. Lil Blue says, peace out of here with those up airs. That's not my thing. I'm not about that speed. I'm about that sit there, tilt the analog stick back and forth, and press Z over and over again. I'm a chic man. How you looking? Needle down tilt forward air. Clinical. Classic Lil Blue. Nightbot is going in. Nightbot is going in on chat. You look back at the chat history, it's just message deleted. All the way to the horizon. Lil Blue has just been mopping up center stage so far this game. But a dash attack will put Lil Blue on the floor, and then he sends into the skies. What is that, a ladder combo? Take it. Take that chain grab, Pikachu. Lil Blue. What should I change Lil Blue's name to on the screen? Submit your votes now. Wait, what just happened? Wait, did OKP just get chain grabbed till 50 and then got forward tilted off stage? Forward tilt to fair off stage, and then he got down tilted to fair for the kill. Is that what happened? Or Nair? Don't get edgehogged. Don't get edgehogged. Game one goes to Lil Blue. Swinging momentum. What can OKP do to turn this around? He has not changed anything. He just keeps getting bodied in center stage. Okay, here we go. Yeah, take that Nair. And take that run off the stage. It was a bait. That's what it was. Don't tell me it was anything otherwise. Clean. Lil Blundy. Lil Blue Jay. Lil Blooge. Lil Blooge. Blooge is nice. The needles. No. No. Yes. Yes. I love edge guards. Some kind of tilt to a fair. What do you know? He's gonna get the punish, chain grab punish, for deciding to run off and miss the up air. And gets that 67% that he gets every time. Goodbye. I think that was a missed platform tech. That was some interesting DI, if not.
Hello.
Yeah. The people.
I'll come see you.
The people have been enjoying it somewhat.
Somewhat?
Yeah.
So, give me the rundown. What have I missed?
What have you missed? You missed OKP popping off in Game 3 because he thought he won Grand Finals.
Oh.
Forgetting that he actually lost Game 1
didn't win. Oh, gosh. He thought he PO'd?
Then, Lil Blue won the next two games
for the
bracket reset.
Oh, my gosh.
And he won Game 1. And so it's kind of looking like a pop-off to get bodied situation here. I was afraid that it was going to happen.
But Lil Blue's up, though.
Yeah, he is.
OKP is your favorite villain, to be honest. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's everybody's favorite villain, actually. It's funny. He's like, he'll just like start talking. But he's a cool guy. I like him. He's my homie.
Lil Blue has just been so consistent with the chain grabs until like 60. And then it's just a matter of like getting a few interceptions and a few more neutral wins.
And a back air, edge guard maybe.
It's just he's been getting a few down tilt to fair, which is really good timing on his part.
Okay.
When he tries to up you to the ledge, he just down tilts and fares perfectly. And he's gotten so many interceptions with those fares. But the edge hog is gonna take it pretty clutch. I'd say
that was actually
he was up a
good
stock.
Comeback, yeah.
Yeah.
He goes Falcon? What do you think about that pick?
I don't know.
Is this the first time picking Falcon in Grand Finals, right?
Yes. I do believe so.
I believe last week when Lil Blue won against OKP, he was playing all Pikachu. So, it actually looks like a good choice. Are we going to see a zero to death?
Ooh, almost.
No. Tech chase? Jared's so consistent with the tech chase, though.
Oh, he read it, but
he
missed the
that.
Execution.
Oh, good. Oh, he's in a corner.
Oh, these
Let's go.
Gates are nuts.
Okay.
Went
the slick, the slick, the slick grab the ledge.
Busted the latex, what I like to call it, going in too hard.
No. Oh, reverse D. Let's go. Let's go.
He's bussing.
And I feel like OKP's got something to prove. He always has something to prove, though. Oh, okay.
This movement is slick. These nairs are pretty.
Yeah. When OKP starts moving and grooving, he actually feels himself.
He's either nairing past every time or just perfectly spacing the nair so that he can't get a grab out of it. And it is
Oh, wow. Sick knee. Sick freaking knee.
Nice shield drop.
Dude. Crispy.
Not sure if the people in the chat know, but the reason OKP can shield drop so well is he actually has a C-stick. He with every controller he gets, he puts a C-stick instead of in place of the analog stick.
Oh, wow. Sick tech. Let's go. He puts a C-stick where his regular stick should be?
Where his analog stick is, yeah.
So then he can get next level angles or something?
Yeah, and it just...
Oh, dang.
His shield drops are so consistent.
That's actually like, next level.
Lil Blue was talking to me. He was using his controller.
Me? Let's go.
He was using OKP's controller. And he said he was trying to miss his shield drop.
He had to try to miss.
But he was getting so many shield drops.
Man.
Like, that's how good his controller is for shield drops.
C-stick on where the analog stick is that next level tech?
I guess it's next level. And the stomp knee below the platform, that hitbox is huge. It's nasty.
Going Dreamland? Puff? Jared's Puff coming out?
Puff.
I'm actually really curious to see how this goes.
There have been so many characters. Guess what game one of the first set of Grand
Finals wasn't
was?
It,
Ness
Game &
Watch?
Yeah.
Oh, that was almost disgusting.
Wow.
That might have been death. If he didn't DI that well.
See, I think Lil Blue can do good if he can get himself some space, some room.
Yeah.
But right now it just looks like freaking.
Oh, jeez.
Let's go.
Did you catch OKP's cheeky little smile at the.
Oh, no.
Falcon punch him. Or not. Good buffer roll. Saw the crouch cancel.
I actually freaking love Little Boost Puff. Actually, I hate playing it, but it's actually kind of cool.
Yeah.
Where he gets those young rests. It's actually kind of sick.
He is a pretty sick Puff.
Even though I'm a little bit against Puff, it's actually kind of cool. Oh, let's go.
He's cooler than HBox. Nice tech.
Oh, yes. Wait, he didn't even tech it. Yeah, yeah.
Wait, he didn't?
No, he just hit the wall.
Looked like I blinked.
I kind of did.
Little blue, it sucks, actually. Doesn't.
Oh, crouching under the grab. Let's go. Freaking Puff gets so big. Puff looks like a pancake when he crouches. Grab. Up throw. Can he get it? No, he mistimed. Dang. Oh! Ooh. The trade, yeah. That's rough.
Just nipped the
That's rough for
tip
Puff.
Of that little pink blob.
He's got to get that. Back air?
My face when I just nipped the tip of that little pink blob. Cray.
This is actually super doable for both players. If Lil Blue can get a rest, or OKP gets a knee.
This matchup is just so volatile. You have rest and knee combos. And it's just, you never know what's going to happen.
That's
and
a rest. Let's go.
As soon as I say it.
How? What's he punishing? Stomp.
Stomp back air.
Okay. He lives. He lives. That's worth.
Yeah, Puff's not going to die on a rest at 30. Unless you're Wizrobe.
He needs room.
Ooh, the jump read. And OKP